warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and best wishes to us all. Welcome to International Webinar 2021. On this special occasion, UGM Jakarta Campus proudly present the first international webinar IOC 2021 Research Network Analysis. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to start our program today by praying. Hopefully, everything that we have planned will run successfully and give us advantage. Ladies and gentlemen, moment of silence begins. Finish. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the committee, we would like to express our sincere gratitude to all the guests and participants. May God bless and lead us in every effort that we do to gain a better future. Before we go to our main program, please let me read out the schedule this event. Our schedule today is as follows. Number one, opening and singing the great Indonesian anthems and hymn Gajah Mada. Number two, welcome remarks from Executive Secretary Universitas Gajah Mada. Number three, presentation from first speaker, Mr. Dr. Eric Kunto, SSMI. And number four, Q&A session one. Number five, presentation from second speaker, Mr. Michael Ma. Number six, Q&A second session. Number seven, door prize announcement. And number eight is closing. Ladies and gentlemen, our next agenda is singing our national anthem of the Republic of Indonesia and hymn Gajah Mada. For this special moment, we are inviting you all to stand up and sing our national anthem Indonesia Raya together.
Indonesia Raya, merdeka, merdeka, merdeka.
Ladies and gentlemen, now is the time for the Executive Secretary Universitas Gajah Mada, Mr. Gugup Kismono, MBA, PhD, to deliver his remarks.
Dear speakers, Dr. Eric Kunto Aribowo and Michael Ma, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It gave me a great pleasure to welcome all of you this afternoon to the international webinar, Research Network Analysis, organized by Universitas Gajah Mada, Jakarta Office. The significance of this webinar is well noticed by many parties, particularly students who are preparing to conduct research and writing thesis. Many students experience difficulties finding research gaps, identifying novelty research topics, especially for students who have other important activities such as working and pursuing a profession outside their campus. Therefore, strategies to solve this challenge are needed. As a result, students can conduct a high-quality research and write well quickly to graduate on time. One strategy to equip students with proper research skills and help them to simplify the literature search process is to use an application, namely ResearchRabbit. ResearchRabbit is a web-based application that can help find research ideas with research visualization integrated with Zotero. With the integration of ResearchRabbit and Zotero, prospective researchers will be more convenient to find research gaps through research visualization and research networks. This webinar is attended by prominent mentors from Indonesia, a Zotero reference management software experts, Dr. Eric Kunto, and from the United States, Michael Ma, experts in utilizing ResearchRabbit. More than 1,300 participants representing 18 countries, including Indonesia, Morocco, Nepal, Bangladesh, Timor Leste, Turkey, Ghana, Cambodia, Australia, Kazakhstan, Pakistan, India, the Philippines, Malaysia, and other countries are registered in today's webinar. Therefore, this webinar will provide us important opportunities to learn and share various contextual issues regarding identifying research gaps, selecting proper literatures, and finding and applying relevant research tools. I would like to take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to the organizers, colleagues at Universitas Gajah Mada, and our honorable speakers and participants. This webinar is also to celebrate Universitas Gajah Mada 72th anniversary. I wish this interesting webinar is useful for all of us. I warmly welcome you again to this important event and enjoy this event. Thank you very much and very good afternoon.
To Mr. Kukup for his remarks, let us word to our main program. The webinar has two speakers. First speaker is Mr. Eric Kunto as lecturer and researcher. Second speaker is Mr. Michael Ma from Research Rabbit. Would you please welcome to Miss Safira Tuhir PhD to create this event. Miss Safira, working at Gajah Mada Library and focusing in international program. Safira is a library focusing on international affairs and also a lecturer in Graduate School of Information and Library Management, Universitas Gajah Mada. She got her master's degree from Curtin University of Technology, Perth, and she got her PhD from the University of South Australia. Welcome, Miss Safira Tuhair, PhD.
Okay. Thank you so much, Maniso. Can you please confirm my voice is clear, right? Yes, thank you so much. Hello, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. Thank you so much for coming to this important activity with the theme Research Network Analysis. This is very important. Why this is very important? It's because today we will share some important information to support you to reach the best in your academic goals. Okay, so I'm sure that all is good with you all today. So I'm Safira from Universitas Gajah Mada. So I will be your moderator today and accompany you all having a serious but relaxing session with two outstanding speakers. Okay, this is also to let you know that we are conducting this session as part of our commitment from UGM Library Jakarta Campus to provide best services to our veteran. Okay, so we are so glad to see some participants from some countries, not only from neighboring countries, but also from countries a bit far from Indonesia. See, oh, great. So thank you so much for the positive energy that we have. So before we start the session, let me just share some points. Our speakers will be speaking in English, then I'm sure that you all can understand English very well. You smart students and smart academics or researchers or lecturers. So there will be no problem for us. But later I will share some points, perhaps in Bahasa, to highlight some important messages from our two speakers, from Eric and from Mike. And please note that you may have questions later. Our first speaker, Eric, is done with the presentation, there will be a Q&A directly. So please write it down in the Q&A box or raise your hand. So your questions can be in English, but also please feel free to write something in Indonesian. So don't worry, I will be very happy to help. And then later, as a token of appreciation, we will have some giveaway later. Yay, so I hope that you're lucky today. Okay, so those are some points that I need to share before we start. And okay, so we are all understand that we are now in academic environment. So teaching and then researching, writing, reading are parts of our life. So I know all parts are very challenging, but when we enjoy them all, things become very light. And today we will focus on one important part of research, that is managing our literature or papers through one reference management tools. Because we know in our research, we will go through some process of reading and then selecting papers and then managing them effectively for sure can save our life, trust me. Okay, so we already have Mas Eric here. I call him Mas Eric. Hi, Mas Eric. I hope everything is good with you, and thank you so much for joining us today. Let me introduce Mas Eric with the audience here. So Eric is a lecturer and also researcher with more than 10 years of experience in the field of sociolinguistics, onomastic language and identity at Widya Dharma University in Klaten. So he's also involved in Indonesian Journal Volunteers. This is a non-profit organization in assisting the management of electronic scientific journals in Indonesia. He is also very enthusiastic when he talks about open science, open data, open method, and open materials. Everything's open. So in order to encourage researchers to research more openly. So he also has his own website, personal website. You can just visit the website at www.erickunto.com. So it's also interesting to know that Eric is previously served as one of the Mandela advisors in 2018 and then starting migrating using Zotero in early 2021. So without any further ado, Mas Eric, please welcome.
Hello, Mbak Fira. Sehat-sehat Mbak Fira ya?
Ya, sehat ya Mas, monggo silahkan.
Oke, thank you Mbak Fira. Nanti kita kombinasi ya, bahasa Indonesia dan bahasa Inggris, dan kita perlu bantuan banyak nih untuk translate ke bahasa Inggris. Oke, let me share my screen first. I hope you see my screen now. Oke, can you see my screen Mbak Fira?
Yes, we can see that clearly. Great.
Okay. Okay, everyone, welcome. Welcome to Indonesia. How are you today? I hope you're doing great. And I'm also glad, I'm also happy to be here with you today. First of all, I would like to thank Gajah Mada, Universitas Gajah Mada, Jakarta Campus Library for inviting me to this awesome webinar. And I hope you learn something new from this session. And honestly, the main course or the main session is after this. You will learn a lot of new insights or new tools about the RabbitMQ. And here I'll try to combine the RabbitMQ and Zotero. So let's start the webinar. Okay, it's me, Eric. I also a lecturer in Indonesia's Widya Dharma Klaten. I also a volunteer in Relawan Jurnal Indonesia, Mbak Safira already mentioned before. And I also passionate about open science, so we can open our research, we can open our data, we can open our method. So if you have any interesting about the open science, please get in touch with me. Okay. So this is my some of profile. So you can check out my social media here. You can check out my recent publication here. And also if you interested about my latest event, just click here and you will be redirected into the material. Yeah. Just click here, click here, click here, and you will get the material. Okay, in today's session, in the first session, I will give you some brief overview about the reference management software, especially in Zotero. So we will learn about how to install some basic Zotero, how to import the reference into our library, how to create citation and train file, and how to generate bibliography. But for the final one, for the last one, I think it's the best one, how to maximize your Zotero. I will give you some trick. I will give you some of my best experience about using Zotero Powerful. So maybe some of you just know about the reference management software or ERM, RMS. So in globally right now, maybe you will find some of interesting names, some of like Shipafi, Review Paper, Zotero, RevWorks, and not mainly JobRef. All of them is reference management software. So when we have a lot of tools, so which one we have to choose? But the simple idea, most of the reference management software can help us to do this part. So save and manage reference, highlight and annotate some important idea. We also can create citation and generate bibliography automatically, so we can be more productive. Yeah? And we can change style citation so easy, just maybe one or two click. It's super easy. Yeah. But my in my observation on my opinion, Zotero and Mendeley become the most popular one in Indonesia, also in globally. I think because it's for free, right? You can download, you can use Mendeley, you can use JobRef, Zotero, Citavi for free, but for papers, RedCube, RevWork, or EndNote, you have to pay some money to use this software. Okay. And here, this is our life without LMS. I guess you already faced this problem, faced this condition, forgot to reference. When we download some PDF file, some paper, we forgot where we save the location. Yeah? Sometimes when we print the paper, then we doing annotation, then we lost the paper. So this is why the developer create the RMS. So with the RMS, we will find this path so easily. We can find and we can search our reference our paper just in search bar, not in Windows Explorer. Just put your keyword, just put the author name, just put the title. So the RMS will find the result here. Yeah, this is why we do need the RMS. Maybe you already use the Microsoft Word citation for citation. It's default by Microsoft Word, but I think it's too difficult to handle the reference management, to handle the reference, because right now we already get the digital reference, the electronic reference. We download the e-paper, we download the e-book. I think it's better if we use the RMS to handle our reference. Okay, what do you think? What's the best RMS today? What do you think? Is it Mendeley? Is it EndNote? Or is it Zotero? But in my opinion, because before I used Mendeley, I think Zotero is the best one. I think Zotero is the best one. Why? You will see my reason here. You can find the full text PDF. So it means that we import all of collection, all of reference in our library in Zotero. Zotero will help us to find the full text PDF. It means that we don't have to download one by one in the PDF file. It's very helpful for me because we can see that article or ebooks open access will be more accessible right now. The second reason why I choose Zotero, because Zotero can give us information about reflected paper. So it's very important. I will give you some example here. I will import some reference by DOI. You can click with this magic stick. Just click this icon and you can paste the DOI. Yeah, you can just paste the DOI from the paper or from the e-books you already read. Yeah. Just press enter. And you will see, and there will be a red label here. Yeah, there will be a red label here. There will be notification and warning here that this work has been retracted. Yeah, and here also information about why this paper has been retracted. It's plagiarism issue, I think. Plagiarism, I think. It's mean when we import our reference into Zotero, Zotero will give us information about retracted paper. So we will never cite the retracted paper. In my opinion, or in my experience, I think only two reference management software have this feature. Only Zotero, and the last one is PaperRedTube is paid version. And the reason, better metadata retrieving. Yeah. You also can import reference by inputting the ISBN. If you have ebook, just copy in the ISBN number, like this one, just input here and copy the ISBN here, then just press enter, and the Zotero will retrieve all the complete metadata above the author, above the title, above the publisher. It will make us easier to import our reference, so we don't have to type manually one by one. Okay, and then we will continue about the one of the best reason why I choose the Zotero is the Zotero have a lot of plugin, maybe around 30 plugins and more. And with these plugins, we can improve our Zotero performance. We can customize, we can give a superpower tools for Zotero, and we will discuss later. And I will recommend you some of this plugin for Zotero. One of them is Sitech. I think you will be interested about this. Okay, then the next reason is in the beta version right now, Zotero also developing a new software, a new version, beta version. In this beta version, if you install Zotero in this beta version, you can read PDF reader. You can read the PDF on the Zotero, yeah, just like in Mendeley, yeah. Just double click the icon, just double click the PDF, and you can right away read the PDF. Then also, if you have an iPad, you can also install Zotero in your iPad. You can also read your paper here. You can also doing annotation right on your iPad, so you can be more productive here. And the last one, Zotero developed by non-profit organization. So I think Zotero didn't interest about our money, but I think we can give a donation for developing this software. And this is the latest issue about Mendeley. I hope you pay attention about this one, because some of the best features Mendeley have been discontinued, and Soon, Mendeley Desktop will be replaced by reference management software. Okay, this is a comparison between Mendeley and Zotero. I think the first two features here already on Mendeley and Zotero, but also here, some interesting, you can create citation in Google Docs. So you can invite your collaborator, you can invite them into your Google Docs document, then you also can create citation right away in Google Docs. So Mendeley didn't have any picture of this. Then you can find a full text PDF. So just import all of your reference in your Zotero, then Zotero will download all the full text PDF open access. Reflection words and the plugin is only you can find in Zotero. So are you ready to move into Zotero? So here, how to install Zotero is super easy. So before you install Zotero, this is a workflow. If you wanna use Zotero to help you doing your research, you need to install Zotero Desktop on your PC, on your laptop, on your Mac, on your Windows. Just install the Zotero Desktop, then install Zotero Connector if you want to import your reference while you browse, while you're searching your paper. And then don't forget to install Word Add-in. So, and this is the plugin. If you want to create citation, you have to install this one. And after you install these three apps, these three connector and three add-in, you need to install. You need to import all our reference into your library. Just import all your reference You can use Google Scholar, you can use Research Private, yeah, and then import into your library. And then if you're ready with your manuscript, you can create citation and generate bibliography. Here is two options or two versions of the Zotero. The first one is the stable version. It's the Zotero 5, I think Zotero 5.0. What I suggest you, I recommended you to try the Zotero beta, because in Zotero beta is a built-in PDF reader. So you didn't have to install another apps, you didn't have to install Adobe, you didn't have to install Nero to open our paper. Just install this Zotero beta, then install the Zotero connector with this icon. You can install in Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Safari, and Edge. Just your favorite browser. Yeah? Just your favorite browser. You didn't have to install all of them. Just install in your favorite browser. Okay, and here, if you want a complete list of the plugin for Zotero, just click this link. And the instruction and the categorization of the plugin, we will get it there. Okay, and this is for the installation for Word Add-in. It's super easy. Just install your Zotero desktop, then open it. Then go to preference, then find the site button here. And don't forget to click this one. Just click this site button here and find this word processor. Word processor, and then install Microsoft Word Add-in. Yeah. Please don't forget to restart your Word after this installation. Then if you want to create citation in Google Docs, just install the Zotero desktop, because there is no need to install a Chrome extension. Just install the Zotero desktop and the plugin, and the plugin or the add-in will already installed in your browser when you open your Google Docs. Yeah. But this is some information about the WPS user. Maybe some of Indonesia author use the WPS, but unfortunately for WPS, it's not supported yet by Zotero. I hope in the next future release, Zotero will support also with WPS. Okay, how to import reference? After we install the Zotero desktop, yeah, today we need to import our reference before we cite or create a bibliography. But first, I think better if you move in the storage location, because by default, Zotero will set up your location storage in C drive. So when you are a Windows user, I think it's better if you change this location into your D drive, so it will back up your data, it will back up your PDF collection, so you don't have to worry. You don't have to worry about the problem issue about Windows and error or something like that. Yeah, please make sure after you install the Zotero desktop, please just change the location into the safe drive. Yeah. Okay, after we install, and this is a six way. I found a six way to import our reference into the Zotero library. So if we already have in the PDF collection, it's super easy. Just drag and drop into your Zotero. Just drag and drop from your Windows Explorer or from your Finder into the Zotero section. Yeah, and the first drag and drop, and second one is digital identifiers, just like our demonstration before. You can input the DOI number or ISBN number, just copy and paste into the magic stick, into the magic stick here, and then paste, then just press enter, and the Zotero will complete the metadata here. Yeah, will complete the metadata. And you can also import your reference by Zotero connector installed in your favorite browser. You can search your reference, you can search your paper, you can search the next reference, the next 8 books, then just click you will find the button here, the icon for Zotero connector here, then they will import into your library. Okay, you can also import your collection by RIS and PipTex file. So these two of files is the most reference management software. So most of the reference management software can read in these two files. So when you want to migrate about the RMS, so maybe like before you use the EndNote, you can export all of your collection, all of your reference using this file, just export as read and then import into your Zotero. So we can also import our collection from RIS and BibTeX file. So you can also export your result from dimension, from length for a public or series, and absolutely also separated. Mike Ma will demonstrate about this feature. Okay, the next one is RSS feeder. Like you can subscribe some of your favorite journal. So when they publish some issue, when they publish their new article, you will get notified. I think it's super cool, this feature. So we don't have to search because Zotero will give us information about the new issue, about the new paper in our favorite journal. So in the last one, it's a manual input. Yeah, in manual input, if you didn't success about the last method, drag and drop, and you didn't find any information about your reference, just put your reference manually one by one by typing the author, title, and et cetera. Okay, I will give you some overview about how to import the drag and drop. It's like this. Just drag and drop multiple, you can do with multiple PDF, or you can just select all to your PDF collection. I think better if you save all your PDF collection in one folder, then select all, just drag and drop into this worksheet. Yeah. Just drag and drop into this file. So just wait a minute, then the Zotero will retrieve all the metadata about the author, about the title. So the Zotero will retrieve all the metadata from the PDF file. Just wait a minute and you'll find the author here, the title here, and all of metadata information here. Here also, you can use ISBN, DOI, PubMed ID, or Archive ID, just by copying the number of ISBN or DOI, and then click this icon. I call it with my magic stick. And then just paste in this column, in this field, then press enter. Then press enter. I will show you how to do this so easy. Just like this. Just copy the DOI and then click this magic button. Then paste the DOI. Then just press the return or enter. If or when your paper, when your imported paper are open access, Zotero will download the full text PDF. So Zotero will help you to download the full text PDF. It's really helpful for me. So just import all of your collection, all of your reference into Zotero. Then if you have lot of collection, maybe just like this. If you have a lot of collection, just like this. Maybe you have a lot of collection, just like this. Just select all, then just right click and click this one, this magic button, find applicable PDF. So when your paper or your reference are open access, so the Zotero will help you to download all of the available PDF. Super helpful for me. Okay, this is for DOI, and you can also import your reference by another way. You can import by Zotero connector, Zotero connector, and you can import by RSS feeder. Just find the icon here in your favorite journal website. Maybe you will find this RSS icon here. Just copy, right click and copy this link. I just right click and copy this link and just put into this. Just input into this new feed, then click copy URL, then just paste the URL here. So when your favorite journal have the new issue or have the new article, so you can make check in this feed, then you also can import this reference into our collection. It's super easy, yeah. This is some of the best feature that we can find in Mendeley, you can find in EndNote. I think it's why we have to choose Zotero. Okay, this is for RIS. You can export your result from Scopus, from Dimension, from Lens, from Publish or Paris. Then just export your result as RIS or BibTeX file. Then just go to file, import, then find the RIS file. Yeah, find the RIS file, and you will find that you will import all of your collection, all of your research. So RIS file is can save multiple collection, can save your multiple reference, maybe 10, maybe 100 reference. You can save just in one file in RIS and BibTeX file. You can import just by one step. Just import all of your collection, export into RIS file, just import into your Zotero using this file. It's also super easy. Okay, this is when you need to input manually, just find the green button here and just the type. You can just podcast, you can just website, you can just a book, and et cetera, et cetera. And unfortunately, we have to type one by one our reference metadata, including title, author, and et cetera, et cetera. Okay, and this is the metadata. Yeah. So we have to make sure after we import our collection, after we import our reference, please make sure that our metadata here, the title, the author, the journal name, the year of publication is already correct here. Just make sure the metadata here are correct, then you can use to your citation or your bibliography. Okay, this is how you can get the full text PDF of open access article. It's also support for open access book. So if you have a link or you have a DOI for open access ebook, just copy in the DOI, just copy in the DOI of your ebooks open access, and just click this magic button and just wait for a second. Then Zotero will download the full text PDF. Okay, yeah. Just make sure the DOI and the URL are available in metadata. Because sometimes when you imported some reference here, you cannot find the URL, so the Zotero cannot help you to find the full text PDF because there is no URL, so Zotero cannot help you to get the PDF. So make sure your reference metadata available in DOI and URL. Yeah. Okay. This is how we can create a citation with Zotero. Yeah. After we imported our reference, then please make check in your Microsoft Word. Yeah. We will be a new menu here, Zotero menu here. Yeah. In the right side of view, just make sure after you install a Word plugin, just restart the Word and make sure that you find the Zotero menu here. If you wanna Well, to create citation, just click in this menu, Zotero, and then click this button, add or edit citation, and just type the name of the author, just type the keyword, just type the title you already memorized, and just choose which reference you want to add or you want to cite, or you want to cite. Yeah? It's super easy. Just click this button, Zotero, on Microsoft Word, and add or edit citation here. And then just type your keyword or author or title. Okay, you also can create a citation in Google Docs. You can see in this screenshot, yeah. Okay, the Zotero menu will also appear here. You also saw some menu here. Just find the Zotero menu. After you open your Google Docs, you will find right in upper menu here. And similar, you can click the add or edit citation. If you want to input your citation, yeah, just click this menu, just click this icon, just click this option, and just type your keyword or just type the title, and the Zotero will search in your database. Zotero will find, will give you the result from your database, and just click which reference you want to edit. Okay, it's easy. I think it's similar in Microsoft Word. You can find this same pop-up menu button on the insert citation. You also can add some additional citation style. Maybe when you open your Zotero, you only get maybe 5 or 7 citation styles, but don't worry, you can edit. You can edit the Zotero style with this tab. You can edit a new APA 7 edition. You can add another style citation with this tab. Yeah, it's super easy. And Zotero maybe around 10,000 and more different citation styles. Yeah, just type your reference name here, and you will find the list of the result, and just click, and Zotero will give you some example how the citation file of this file. Okay, after you add your citation, of course you will generate a bibliography. Yeah, also super easy. You can click the Zotero menu from Microsoft Word, yeah. Just find this icon, add or edit bibliography. Just find this icon and just wait for a couple of seconds, and directly the bibliography will pop up automatically. Also, this is the screenshot for Google Docs. Just go to Zotero menu and find the add or edit bibliography. And the process will be right. Will be like this. Just click Zotero, then click the add or edit citation, then the complete list of your reference, will be writing automatically here. Yeah, you can also do this step in Google Docs. Same, just click Zotero and then click add or edit citation, add or edit bibliography, just like this. Okay. And this is our favorite moment. This is how to maximize your Zotero. I can give you some of my best practice. But first, I think you have to install the Zotero beta. So you can read the PDF file and you can doing annotation, just write in your Zotero software, just like this. Then you can highlight some important idea, you can highlight some important text, and you also can add some important annotation here. Just click this one and you will you can read, you can write your idea, you can write your annotation here. And this is how you can download the beta version. Just what version or what operating system you use, so Mac, Windows, or Linux, just click this one. And just make sure if you already installed the stable version, you need to uninstall the stable version before you install the beta version. Okay, I think this is the one of the best feature in Zotero. You can read, you can annotate your PDF collection on your Zotero. Second tip, you can install third-party plugin. You can upgrade your Zotero into maximum power. This is three of plugin I recommended you to install it in your Zotero. The first one is Site. Yeah. Site, it can help us to see the context behind citation, because the citation is mainly for us, but not only for the number, but we have to look what's the context behind the number. So the Site AI is, I think it's a good, I think it's one of the good apps we can help us to identify, because when the paper gets citation here, we can find where the citation location. Just like this, we get the 89 citation in introduction. We get the citation in method section. We have 11 citation in the result section. So with this Site AI, with this Site AI plugin, we can realize that the citation has a context. Context is supporting, mentioning, contrasting, and unclassified. Supporting means that the citation has agreement with this claim. And contrasting, it means that disagree. Yeah? It means disagree. So we have to look what the numbers say. Is it supporting, is it mentioning, or is it contrasting? Yeah, I think it's one of the best plugin I can offer to you to install. And second one is Zotero, .file. And it can help us to manage our PDF file in Zotero. And the third plugin is Papyr. Papyr is like a platform. We can add comment from the new paper or from the new manuscript. So we can also read some of comment from the manuscript with this plugin. Yeah, this is I will show you the complete report of the Site AI. Just click this picture and you will get into this link. Okay, and this is a new software. I think Site AI can help us to find what's behind citation, what's the context behind citation. Is it supporting? Is it mentioning? Is it only mentioning or is it contrasting to the agreement, to the claim of the paper? We need to try this plugin, I think. Yeah. This is where the location of the citation, introduction, method, result, discussion, and this is the context of the citation, supporting, mentioning, or contrasting. And they also can identify the type of publication, also for self-citation. Yeah. Okay. This is the last one, I think, before we jump into Q&A. Okay, SuiteRabbit. Okay, SuiteRabbit is also a new platform. Maybe October or July. October or July is released in official release, and there is an official version. It's...
Hi, I'm Krishnan with ResearchRabbit, and today we'll walk through the integration between ResearchRabbit and Zotero. To start, click the Connect to Zotero button on the left-hand side of the screen. From here, you can sign into Zotero and click Accept Defaults to proceed. From here, you can close the tab and return to ResearchRabbit to continue. Once you've connected your Zotero account, you'll be able to sync any of your existing collections in ResearchRabbit to Zotero as well. So let's open a collection and click the Sync to Zotero button at the top. From here, you'll be able to add a name for your destination collection in Zotero. And we see that it's successfully created and synced. And when we go over to Zotero, we'll see that the collection is here as well. You can also import collections from Zotero into ResearchRabbit. To do that, click the Import Zotero Collection button on the left-hand side of the screen and choose a collection to sync. Choose a name for your collection in ResearchRabbit and hit Enter. ResearchRabbit will then sync the papers from your Zotero collection to ResearchRabbit. If your papers have identifiers such as DOIs, they will be much more likely to add correctly. Should these fields be missing in your Zotero, ResearchRabbit will try to find the paper by using the paper title. If we find matches based on the title, we will show them to you in a window where you can confirm that our paper suggestion is the correct match. If none of the suggested matches are accurate, you can try adding the paper's DOI into Zotero and syncing again, or clicking None of these are right to skip the paper. You can add or remove papers in either ResearchRabbit or Zotero and see the changes appear in the other place. So we'll add a paper to our collection in ResearchRabbit, then hit Resync with Zotero, and if we go over to Zotero, we'll see that this paper now appears in our collection. We can also go into Zotero and remove this item from our collection, make sure we sync, and then go back into ResearchRabbit and hit Resync with Zotero, and we'll see that the paper is now gone. For more information, check out our FAQ page linked in the description. If you want to book a setup or help session with our team, click the Calendly link on the FAQ page.
Okay, and there's some demo about the integration between Zotero and ResearchRabbit. I think you'll get information, a lot of information about ResearchRabbit after the session. But before that, I think also you can find this integration, or you can combine this Zotero with another Publish or Paris. You can also use the lens to take some information about the reference. Just try to click this one. It's also, you can find the video tutorial. And this is the last one for the best trick for Zotero. It's only for Gajah Mada student. In the basic account, we can get 300 megabytes for cloud storage for the Zotero. So you can save, so you can synchronize our collection into the cloud. But if you want to upgrade your storage, just use your web tab from UGM. You can use this feature, you can use this facilitation from the Gajah Mada. You can use your email, just copy this link and set up the web dev backup. Just follow this step and copy in this link, and you can use your Gajah Mada email, and you can use your email password, and you will get storage up to 7 gigabytes. I think it's a lot of space we can use to save and store our PDF. So we didn't have to worry about the loss of data. So we can access the web desk academic staff, of course, and the lecturer, and active student. And the good news is UGM alumni also can use this facilitation, or you can use this feature. Thank you for UGM, and I hope you will give this feature, you will give this webdev forever for alumni, so we can use the 7 GB for our story. I think that's for me, Mbak Safira.
Yes.
Mudah-mudahan clear ya.
Sangat jelas sekali, Mas. Ya, terima kasih sekali Mas Eric sudah menjelaskan introduction for us. So, thank you so much Mas Eric, a very insightful perspective for introduction. Thank you so much for sharing with us. Some points why Zotero is very useful. So this is to avoid to make mistake if we have this reference management software, because one common mistake is that sometimes we have the citation in the body text, but then we forgot to list it in the reference list. So this will help. And yes, if we say only have 10 papers, this is too easy to organize that manually. But imagine if we have 500, 600, or 700 papers for your master's degree or for your PhD, for example. So I got 700 papers for my PhD. So having the reference management software will save your life, trust me. And also using this, we will just find it easier if we want to check the paper again in the future. So let's say when you have like around 2020, and then you are not so sure what it is, and then you can just check again. If you have that software, it will be very useful for you. Okay, so I believe that we already have some questions. For Mbak Nufa, could you please just help organize the questions by sharing the screen, please? Perhaps Mas Eric bisa stop sharing first, then Mbak Nufa can just help us to share the screen. Thank you. So we have questions here, Mas Eric. Is there any software that which can help me to store a statement that I found in an article? I often read statement then forgot the source when typing it. Yes, please, Mas Eric. Yes, it's coming from.
I think you can use Zotero beta version, but in Zotero beta version, we can add some of. Okay, you can just go to Zotero beta version and then open the PDF file, and you can add the annotation in that document. Maybe I can share my screen.
I'm not so sure. Perhaps Mbak Nufa can just, yes, okay.
Okay, just go to Zotero. I think you need to install the Zotero beta version for this feature. After you import your document and the PDF, just double-click. Just double-click the icon or double-click the PDF. Then you can highlight some important idea. Maybe it's like this. You can highlight some important idea. Maybe just like this. You can highlight, and you also can add annotation. Just click this icon. Just click where you want to add some text or some argument or some sentence you want to add. Just like this.
Mas Eric, perhaps what about if we already have the citation and then we forgot from which paper, how can we find that paper for example, okay, I have this some sentences that I already cited, but then for some reason, like I lose all that, and I accidentally close the documents, and then, oh, where is the source? And then, is there any way in Zotero that we can search that sentence match with that document?
Okay. If you find that issue, I think the best one is just copying the argument, copying the claim, and then just find in Google Scholar or Google.com. I think they will give you some information about that.
Okay. Jadi mungkin jelas ya pertanyaannya, jika kita lupa dari mana itu berasal, ya udah di search aja dulu, siapa tahu ada gitu. Tapi tadi Mas Erik menerangkan bahwa kita juga bisa menandai atau mengambil beberapa poin atau beberapa bagian lewat Zotero. Jadi bisa dua, kita bisa ambil, atau juga kalau kita kehilangan sumber, kita juga bisa cari lagi, tapi itu lewat tadi, kita coba googling.
Gitu. Ya. Karena itu adalah salah satu fungsi dari reference management software ya teman-teman ya. Jadi kita tinggal input semua PDF-nya di dalam Zotero, jadi kita tidak perlu simpan di Windows Explorer karena juga akan susah kan kalau kita mau mencari kan. Jadi kita bisa simpan aja di Zotero semua PDF file-nya, dan kita kalau ingin melakukan anotasi, kita ingin memberikan catatan, tinggal lewat sini aja. Tinggal nanti ketika ini ditutup dan teman-teman ingin mengecek kembali catatannya tadi, nanti akan muncul di bagian sini. Nah, nanti akan muncul di bagian sini. Ya, jadi tidak akan hilang ya, catatannya tidak akan hilang.
Oke.
Okay. Gitu.
Sepertinya useful sekali. I hope the first question answered well. So can we please move to the next questions? Mbak Nova. Yep. Okay. When we teach students about how to write and organize the reference, then it is important to teach them how to write reference manually, or better to teach directly how to use Mendeley or Zotero. Thank you so much for the questions.
Okay. I think it's clear the answer. I think it's better if you use the reference management software. Because Mbak Fira already mentioned that sometimes he facing the issue that the citation in body text but never show up in the bibliography and vice versa. I think it will make us some trouble. We can be more productive if we can use the reference management software. So just export or just save all of your reference in Zotero, and then you will find and you will read, you will give annotation just in one software, just in Zotero. So you will never confuse about the mistype for the author name. You didn't have to worry about the not complete, incomplete metadata. Because it's the main function, the basic function of the reference management is to help us to menghapuskan permasalahan-permasalahan ini ya.
All right. Thank you so much. I really agree what Mas Erik just explained. So I also always suggest or encourage my students, even if they have like 10 papers, 10 citations in their papers, they still need to exercise or practice using the software. And yes, as what Mas Erik explained, that it's better for us to teach or encourage them to use the software, but still, we need to double check and check again. Sometimes, the process of importing data is not that reliable. I mean, the metadata from the source are not complete. For example, they should have the year, but then sometimes we didn't have that. So, once again, you still need to check manually in the reference list resulted by, say, Zotero. And then if we find some incomplete information or metadata, then you need to go to that software and then just try to edit it, make sure it's complete. and then just go back to the Word document and then refresh that. Because if you find it incomplete in that Word and then you try to revise it in Word, sometimes when you close that and then when you open again, and then it will not work very well. Perhaps that's the additional important thing. I think it's quite clear. So, Mas Eric, thank you so much. Can we proceed to the next question, please? If I already use Mendeley, is it possible to do a migration? Or maybe I can use both them simultaneously without crash? Please.
Okay, I think the last question is just use one of your best reference management software. You can use Zotero, you can use Mendeley, you can use EndNote. It depends on your preference. But in my opinion, in my experience, if you compare Zotero with Mendeley, I think better if you use Zotero, because there's a lot of useful thing, useful feature, just like reflection watch. They didn't have in Mendeley. It will prevent us to cite the reflected paper. I think it's very important. And if you want to migration, it's a good news for me. I mean, will be more Zotero user. I think you can check this tutorial. I already create some tutorial about how to migration from Mendeley into Zotero. Just follow this tutorial. And if you want clearly, if you want to obviously want to migration from Mendeley into Zotero, just install the beta version. Because in the beta version, you will get the option migration or imported collection from Mendeley. You can check this link. You can check this link. Already write in the tutorial here how to migration from Mendeley. Because from the beta version, they have this option, Mendeley Reference Manager. You can import online import from your database from your Mendeley. And just follow these steps, and I think you can easily migration from Mendeley into Zotero. Right.
Yeah. So this is possible, right?
It's possible. Yeah.
Yes, it's possible to do that. But then the suggestion is just choose one software and then be consistent. I think this is like easier rather than having like two software. Okay, so I think it's clear. So we now will just give the chance to the audience by raising hands. Is there anyone that would like to ask questions? We just give you the chance by raising hands and then we'll just open your mic. Okay, so yes, we can see some.
What most particular software so that we can use in teaching for my teachers, sir? Because as of now we are in pandemic, we are new normal of teaching for. We are using ICT and gadgets. Can you suggest, sir, the most easy software that we can store in our computer to make the learning more easier and more manageable for our pupils?
Thank you so much, Cynthia. Do you mean the software for managing reference or any other software in supporting teaching? Because we're talking about the reference management tools.
Any software that can manage for teaching and teaching pupils, ma'am, especially in long distance learning.
Okay, so this is for the elementary or for the university or the
elementary.
Mas Erik, ini pertanyaannya umum sekali dan mungkin suggest saja beberapa, kemudian nanti kita akan pindah ke pertanyaan yang lain mungkin kalau misalnya Mas Erik punya suggestion.
Tentang aplikasi untuk pembelajaran online gitu ya Mbak ya?
Iya, so about the, just if you have some ideas, just please share shortly, then we can just like discuss other questions.
Okay, I can recommend you some of useful apps. You can try Wakelet. Wakelet can help us to curation learning material from YouTube, from social media, from Google Docs, from Canva, for everything they, if they have an online version. So it's just like opportunity mapping. Yeah, it's like mapping. You can create your collection, including your material. You also can right away record your speech, you record your screen recording in Wakelet, and you also can use Kahoot. You can use Kahoot. I think the apps you need to try first is Wakelet. So I think you can wait. I can give you the link maybe. Just go to wakelet.com and it's free and all the time. Free forever. There's no trial, no trial version.
Yeah.
And if you interested with this Wakelet, I also have learning material. You can learn by yourself with this material for me. And just go to wakelet.com. Yep.
Okay. So wakelet.com and then Kahoot and then some other supporting software that can help in in teaching the online distance. Okay.
And you will find another useful application. Just go to my website and I give some review about the software, some update about the feature of the software. Just go to my website and I help you find some benefit from my blogging.
Okay. Thank you so much. It's very helpful. I think we already tried to answer some questions, but I know it still has some more, but we need to go to the next speaker today. I would like to thank Mas Erik for sharing with us today. It's very great, and we really learned a lot from you, and I'm sure that this is very useful for the audience there. So thank you so much, and hope to see you again in the in the next
session.
Okay, you're welcome.
It's my honor for me, Mbak Fira. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Hi, Mike.
Hello, Eric.
Thank you so much, Mr. Eric. Thank you, Mr. Michael Ma and Miss Safira. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let us appreciate the speakers and moderators delivered this performance greatly. Next agenda is the distribution of door prize. We invite the committee to prepare. So Mbak Putri, please do us follow. There are 5 door prize, and the one who get is Miss Putri. Okay. Number one is Atira K. Congratulations. Next, stop. Yes, Auditya Purwandini ya. Okay, congratulations. Stop. Leonardo F. Chada Jr. Congratulations. Next. Stop. Okay. Chanchi Montano, congratulations. And last one. Stop. Muhammad Daniel MPD, congratulations. Congrats to the lucky ones. Okay, thank you, Mbak Putri. Ladies and gentlemen, finally we come to the end of the event. As the presenter, I am really sorry if there are mistakes in bringing this event. We appreciate your willingness to join and participate in our program today, and see you at the next program. Goodbye and stay healthy, everyone. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.